Our kitchen is really our heart of the home. We tend to spend quite a bit of time and energy dishing out ours and our family's favorites, which can be quite exhausting at times. Namaste, welcome to Home Hashtag Life. If you are newly married, learning new ropes in the kitchen just now, I'm sure these tips will come handy for you. And if you already know these tips, I hope you will enjoy watching this video. So, let's get started. I have divided these tips as cooking time tips and general kitchen time tips. First, let me share the general kitchen time tips that will prep you as not just a great cook, but a disciplined one too. Many times, we just reach for the tissue, tear it off, wipe and throw. If we take a second to reflect on this, we will realize that it is a wastage of paper and money. I use the paper towel when it's absolutely unavoidable. So what we can do? Just take any old cloth, cut it into really small bits and pieces and store it in a cute basket or kitchen container, or store it inside the cabinet door. At it's all about the convenience. When there is any oil spill or any other spill, reach for the cloth, wipe it down and throw. Depending on the amount of spill, you can simply rinse it and reuse it a couple of more times. First, if the pressure cooker malfunctions, one of the reasons could be the gasket has lost its shape. Store the gaskets in the freezer. It will hold the shape and last very long. Second, many times the rubber gasket and the weights get mixed up and we may end up looking for them. So make it as a habit to place the respective weight of a cooker inside the cooker itself, so as not to get confused while in hurry. Third, before you use the cooker, especially if you cook millets or any similar family grains in them, you know how messy it can get if the weight's path is not clear. So make sure you blow and see that the air path or airway is free. I use a safety pin to clear the path, which I store right here inside this drawer. Forks, ladles, vessels, yes, those definitely are in the kitchen. But a screwdriver? You have no idea how helpful it could be if the screwdriver is within the reach. I have shared this tip years ago in this kitchen tour video. Many of the handles of vessels or pressure cookers become loose very easily. When not attended to in time, this can cause a lot of accidents and burns. So whenever you see a handle or any part that is going to loose, grab the screwdriver from the drawer and tighten the screws. When you buy onions, garlic, potato, don't store them just like that. Peel off the thin layer on top, dust them off and then place them in the container. Two benefits will be there. One, using them immediately becomes easy. Two, our kitchen counter won't get messy and will give a neat to clean look to the storage area. This is one of the best tips I have ever learned from How Jen Does It in my early YouTubing days. Keep a bowl or container to catch kitchen waste as you cook. Now it has become a habit of mine and I am able to maintain this white kitchen counter without much fuss. Let me give a little bit of context. Nowadays, we use a bit of fancy kitchen towels as a decor to enhance the look of our kitchens and of course to wipe our hands. We have only two hands, but the kitchen requires a few hundred. But as you know, kitchen work can be so messy and it takes just a blink to get our towels dirty and stained. So along with the kitchen towel, I keep a small cloth on the counter. Whenever I need to wipe my oily or dirty hand before opening the cupboard or the spice dabba, I pause for a microsecond, wipe my hand first in the small cloth and then touch anything. These homemaking practices may seem really small, but they go a very long way in maintaining a neat or clean kitchen. Before you exit the kitchen for the day, make sure you wipe the barthan box, wash chakla belan, remove any spills with a kitchen cleaner and make sure the sink drain is clean and dry. Wipe down the kitchen counter without fail. If you are not washing vessels that night, make sure to remove any food debris on plate and vessels and soak them in water. This will prevent insects and cockroaches keep growing. Keep the kitchen looking spick and span to welcome you in the next morning. This is an often undervalued practice, but one that can be immensely useful and save time. When you have a handy water jug, you don't have to keep opening the tap every now and then. Use the jug directly to wash poha or soak rice or dal or to add the cooker or to sprinkle on the veggies or for whatever else. For each of these, imagine if you keep opening the tap, you might end up wasting water and wasting time. While you organize your kitchen countertop, designate a spot for a water jug. Make sure you don't waste time by using an old or unsharpened knife. Many times this is a time stealer. We keep cutting but it is not efficient or sharp. Sharpen the knives by rubbing it behind the teacups as a hack and ensure you pick the right knife for the right cut. A serrated knife works like magic on tomatoes or onions. But that knife is not at all useful when we need to cut a big watermelon. Instead of serrated knife, we can use a big, sharp, all-purpose knife to slice and dice in no time. The important thing to remember is to have a combination of the right ones and the sharp ones. We use lemon in most of our cooking, for salads, for dals, etc. Instead of reaching out every time and squeezing a lemon, squeeze about 10 to 15 of them, add a pinch of salt and store it inside the fridge. Take it when required, saves so much time.
Wish that I could stay in this moment forever so I can hold you in my arm. I will carry you.
Additional tip, before squeezing, roll the lemons nicely. You can extract more juice out of it. Soaking dal and rice for at least half an hour, chana and the other legumes overnight not only speeds up the cooking, it has many health benefits. When rice is soaked and rinsed, it gets rid of phytic acid that prevents the absorption of minerals. The same goes for legumes and pulses too. Do read up more about this in the link provided in the description box below. You have already seen my Kitchen Happy Helpers video. Beside those helpers, I also like to use my chopper for efficient and quick chopping. Saves so much time and energy. Let me share a time-saving cooking hack here. Add curd or dahi, onion, cucumber, salt, red chili, cumin powder, and a little bit of chaat masala directly into the chopper. Then just give it a few pulses. Your chopper raita is ready within seconds. only the texture will be different, but the taste will be unbeatable. If you have an electric chopper, give it a try and comment how it goes. Always let the oil heat and then add the tadka. Let the mustard seeds or zeera splatter well to enhance the taste of the dal or curry. You can use a small plate to cover the tadka pan in case you want to avoid the mustards from splattering everywhere. Never choose this type of saucepan for making tea or boiling milk. If you are making oats or reheating food, then that's okay. But not for any liquids. It will definitely spill, though it has a spout. And spills always mean wasting precious time in cleaning those irritating spills. Always go for this type of saucepans which has a convex edge. Liquids never spill. This is a bonus and a super tip I have learned from Bisfully Random YouTube channel. Put your steel kadhai or pan on the stove. Keep the flame on high and let it heat for a minute. Drop water. If the water evaporates, it means it hasn't reached its smoke point. Keep checking one more time and you will see the water becomes droplets or just like pearls and does not evaporate from the pan. Now your pan is ready for cooking. Food won't stick much in the steel kadhai or pan and the result? No more wasting time trying to dislodge stuck food on your steel kadhai. Be sure to give this video a big thumbs up. Your likes really means a lot to me. And don't forget to share this video with your loved ones, especially with our newly married ones. And you can always find us on Instagram and Facebook for new videos, pictures, and life updates. And don't forget to subscribe to Home Hashtag Life. I will see you in the next one. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.